Hi everyone, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to see the lesson name Digital Presentations. Under Digital Presentation we are going to see the following topics. First one is creating a presentation and second one creating a presentation using template or using a model sample, then selecting slide layout or slide designs, and then adding text, then saving a presentation, then saving a presentation with different name and saving a presentation with different format. Like PDF and HTML format, and running a slideshow, and then saving a presentation as HTML, saving a file in a PDF format, and then closing a presentation and opening a presentation, then using help. So these are the subtopics we are going to cover in today's class. So let me move on to the first topic, that is creating a presentation. So here we are going to use LibreOffice Impress only. So to create a new blank presentation, we need to select a file menu and new option from the file menu, or click on icon new, okay, or use the combination of keys Control plus N. So that is together Control key and N key you need to press in order to open a new blank presentation in that is the LibreOffice Impress software. And then a window select a template will appear. So once you click on this Control plus N or a new icon, or if you choose file menu and new option, immediately you will get a window that is showing like select a template, that like will appear, and then choose a template as per your choice. So many templates you will see, many samples you will see, in that you need to choose according to your choice by clicking on the template as shown in the figure to start preparing the presentation. So we need to choose any one of the template, that is sample or model we need to choose. So here itself we will have some of the colors and some format, text format, everything will be appearing, some designs, some colors, like a background color, and title box alone will be appearing in different color. So like that we can get some samples. So in that you need to choose any one of the sample which you like most, okay. Then after that you need to prepare your presentation using a template. After selecting one template, so the selected template will appear in the form of title slide layout as shown in the following figure. So like this, if you have chosen any one of the slide layout or slide template which you like most, then it will be appearing like this in the presentation. So here you will see, click to add title in order to give the heading. So like this you can give the heading, and down you can add the contents, okay. Next, when creating a presentation, the first slide is normally the slide title slide. So as we saw earlier, so the first slide always will be click to add title. Then you can use either a blank layout or one of the title layout as per your title slide. So according to the title, either you can go for blank layout. There will be many layout, like around 12 layout you can get. In that you can choose either blank layout or one of the title layouts. We will see some of the layouts samples also now. Now enter the title text in the slide as shown in the figure. So like this you need to type the title LibreOffice Impress, like that you can give the title at the top, okay. So like this creating a presentation, I have entered in the title box only. Same like here you can enter LibreOffice Impress in a title box, then below that you can add the contents. So the appropriate layout can be selected from the layout sections. As we said already, either you can choose blank layout or some of the title layouts also, as per your choice you can choose. So the layout can be selected from the layout section in the properties window. So right side of the LibreOffice Impress, no, you will have the properties window. So from that you can choose the layouts. So the layouts included in the LibreOffice range from, so how it will be ranging from, so how many layouts will be there in the LibreOffice. So it will be ranging from blank slide to a slide with 6 content boxes under title as shown in the following figure. So you can see here in the properties window, that is this will be appearing at the right side of your presentation software, okay. So in this under this properties you need to click on this layouts, okay. So under the layouts you will have many layouts, as we said discussed already. It will start from, layout will be starting from blank layout. So this is fully blank. Either you can add image or title alone, you can copy and paste, okay, any content you can copy and paste in a blank layout. And this is title, and what example we have seen in previous slides, no? So like that, title and then content. So this like also layout will be available. So like that, we have around 15 layouts. It will be ranging up to title with 6 content boxes. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 content boxes. Content means some text we can add. Okay, so or some images we can add inside every content box. Okay, so like this, around 12 slide layouts we have. Among these 12, we can choose whichever slide layout is suitable for our content. We can choose any one of the layout. So you can also select a slide layout by using, this is another one way, by going to properties window, and from that properties window, if you click on layouts, you can see many layouts options will be available. From that you can also, you can choose. The another way is, you need to go to slide menu in the menu bar, and then slide layout, and then title slide as shown in the figure. So like this, slide menu you need to click in the menu bar, then slide layout. In this right arrow will be there, so it will be showing whatever slide layouts we have, that names alone will be displayed here. You can choose any one of the slide layout, like title, 6 content, 4 content, 2 content over content. So like that, we have around from blank slide to title with the 6 content we have. Okay, so any one of the slide layout you can choose. So these are the slide layouts. You can choose any one among these layouts. Okay, this is one way of choosing slide layout. So the layout you have selected will be applicable in the right side of the window. Alternatively, you can select the slide in the slide pan. It will appear in the workspace, and here you can select the required layout from the layout section in the sidebar. So sidebar, as we said already, sidebar also different layouts will be available in under the property section. From that slides also, you can choose any one of the slide format. If you want to add a text, next one is adding text. If you want to add a text to the slide that contains a text frame, click on click to add text in the text frame and then type your text. So this is called a text frame. Okay, so in this, inside this, you need to click. After you get the cursor, that is blinking line, vertical blinking line will appear, no? That is only known as cursor. So after you get the cursor, you can start type the text. So the outline styles are automatically applied to the text as you insert it. So once you type the text, the styles will be automatically applied to the text. So like this, you can add the text. Okay, LibreOffice Impress, features of LibreOffice Impress. Like that, we can add a text to the text frame. Okay, then saving a presentation. Once we have entered the content, how to save a presentation we will see. While creating a presentation, you can save it to the disk with some name. Okay, you will be having hard disk drive, C drive, D drive, E drive. So like that, you have a disk. So you need to save the presentation with some name so that the content may not be lost. Why we want to save? In order to safeguard the content, and then we can use the presentation in the future purpose. No, we can save it and we can make use of the presentation. Okay, to save the presentation, you are working on the following steps as given below. We need to select the file menu and then save. Okay, if you want to save any presentation, you should go for file menu and then save option you need to choose. Or you can go for shortcut key combination, that is Control plus Yes, or you need to click on the save button on the standard toolbar. So this will open the save dialog box as shown in the figure, following figure, which allows to select the location on the disk and assign the name to the presentation. See here, once you have selected the file menu and then save option, it will open save dialog box like this. Okay, you need to enter the name. Okay, presentation name, my first presentation, like this. You can enter the name of the presentation here. Defaultly, the presentation will be saved in the type. Save as type will be, this is file name box. Under this, we are typing, inside this, we are typing the file name. Here, this is called save as type. So, which type, which file type we are saving. So, defaultly, even if you are not mentioning the presentation file format, it will be defaultly saved as ODP format, .odp. This is the default extension of LibreOffice presentation files. Okay. So here in this checkbox, no, automatic file name extension, it is enabled. So if it is enabled, means automatically it will be saved with .odp extension. So if you want to save your presentation with the password, you can set the password for this presentation. Then means even if anyone is opening without your knowledge, so if they know the password only, they can able to open your presentation and they can view the content. So for that purpose, this, for the security purpose, we can make use of this checkbox, save with password. If you enable this, it will ask for a password from you and you can give the password. Okay, then finally, after giving all the information, then you need to select the location where you want to save your presentation, either in desktop or inside the documents or inside a C drive or D drive or a USB. Like that, you need to choose the location from the left side, this bar we have, no? Inside, from this you need to choose the location where you want to save. So to change the location in drive, open the directory in which you want to save the file. So here you can choose whichever directory you want to save. You need to choose the location, okay? So enter the name of the presentation file in the file name box, okay? Then you need to click on save. If the presentation is already saved, the contents will be updated in the presentation file. Next, if you want to save the presentation with a different name, you need to go for file save as option. Instead of save, which option? Save as option, in order to save with a different name. If you want to give a new name for that, for the already saved presentation file, you need to go for file and save as option, or you can go to shortcut key shift plus control plus S. So normal saving a presentation will be using control plus S key alone. But if you want to give a different name, new name for the saved presentation, you can click on shift plus control plus S key. You need to press these three keys together in order to open file save as dialog box, okay? So once the save as dialog box appears, you can give the new file name, and the file name, in the file name field, you need to enter the new file name, and then saving is finished by using the save button. So like this, you need to enter the file name here, new file name you need to give here, and choose the file format also, whichever file format you want to save, you choose the file format here from the save as type by clicking this down arrow, okay? And then you can save the presentation by clicking on save button. So by default, the presentation is saved with which extension? .odp extension. Here you can see .odf presentation. ODF presentation, that is shortly called as .odp. What is the full form of ODP? ODF presentation only. To save a presentation as another file type, you need to click on file save as, and then you can choose from save as dialog box, no? All the formats drop down menu, you need to click on, and then select the choice from the offered programs. For example, Microsoft PowerPoint 97 2000 XP, then /2000 for saving your presentation with .ppt extension. Or if you want to save the PPT PowerPoint with the .pptx extension, you need to go for this, you need to select this type as like this, okay? You need to select the save as type from the format, that is save as format drop down list. We can select the type of the file like this, okay? And then next one is how to run a slideshow. So once you've finished all the slides with complete contents, no, you can run the slideshow by clicking on slide menu, slideshow menu, and clicking on start, or from the first slide on the main menu bar. That is, if you want to run the slideshow, you need to click on the slideshow menu and then start from first slide option. You need to choose from the main menu bar, or else click the slideshow icon. Slideshow icon will be available in the presentation toolbar or the slide shorter toolbar. We will have the slideshow icon, okay? Or else you can press the F5 key from the keyboard, okay? So in the three ways, using icon and then using slideshow menu, and start from first slide option in the main menu bar, or from the toolbar, slideshow icon you need to click, or press F5, the slideshow start to run from the first slide, okay? So by clicking on the mouse button, so how we can move on to the next slide? So we need to click on the mouse button. So we need to click mouse once in order to move to the next slide, or else you can use the arrow keys from the keyboard, okay? If you want to use the arrow keys, no, up arrow, down arrow, it will go to up. If you use up arrow, it will go to previous slide. If you use down arrow, it will go to next slide. So we can also press the spacebar key on the keyboard to proceed to the next slide. So if you press the spacebar, if you use arrow key, up arrow, it will go to previous. And if you click on a down arrow, no, press the down arrow, it will go to next one. So but spacebar key is used to move to the next slide only, okay? We cannot move previous slide with the help of the spacebar key, okay? So these are the ways we can move to the slides. And right click anywhere on the screen to open a menu for navigating the slides and set the other options. So if you want to move to first slide to 10th slide or 10th slide to 8th slide, you can right click on the screen, okay? And one menu will be opening. From that, you can choose which slide you want to move, slide 1, slide 2. See, right, like this, you need to right click on the slide, okay, on slideshow. In the screen, seen as go to slide is there, no? So from by clicking on this go to slide option, we can go to any slide. So in this way also we can move to the any slide. Here I have typed around 35 slides from the first slide to 35 slide. Now I am in as 26th slide. So if I want to move to 15th slide, I can click on 15th slide. So it will be taking us to 15th slide. So like this also we can right click on the slide and we can click on go to slide option and we can choose the whichever slide we want to move. So in this way also we can navigate to the slides. We can move across the slides. In the last slide, you will get a message, click to exit presentation. Once when we are running a slideshow, when we go to last slide, we will get the message like this, that is click to exit presentation. Okay, so just click the mouse button or press any key on the keyboard to exit the presentation. If you want to exit the slideshow at any time, okay, even at the middle, if you want to exit the presentation, you need to click on which key? Escape key, ESC key from the keyboard. In the keyboard, left, top left corner, this key will be placed. You can click this ESC key, this escape key, in order to exit the slideshow at any time. Next one is how to save a presentation as a HTML format. So to publish the presentation on the web or to open the presentation in the web browser. Okay, if you want to open the same presentation file in a web browser like Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome, like that we have many web browsers, no? If you want to view the presentation in the web browser or publish the presentation on the website, you need to save the presentation in which format? HTML format. That is hypertext markup language format, which could be opened in any web browser. So to save the presentation as a HTML, you need to click on file export. You should not go to file menu and save option. You need to click on file and export. Select the directory in which you want to save the file. So in which location you want to save your file, you need to select the location or directory and choose HTML document impress format from the save as type. Enter a file name, click save. Okay. Then if you want to save a file in PDF format, that is portable document format. What is the full form of PDF? Portable document format of the presentation can be created by saving a file in PDF format, which can be viewed with the help of free Adobe Acrobat Reader. So with the help of this software, Adobe Acrobat Reader, we can view the presentation in the PDF format. However, how to save the file in PDF format? No, to save a file in PDF format, we need to click on file again, export as PDF. We need to select the directory where you want to save the file and then enter a file name, click save. How to close the presentation? If you want to close the presentation, we need to click on file menu and then close, or else Ctrl plus W from the keyboard. Shortcut key, we need to click like this, okay? Then open a presentation again, file, open, or else you need to click the shortcut key from the keyboard, Ctrl plus A, sorry, O, okay? Ctrl plus O for opening a presentation, okay? Ctrl plus A for selecting all the text. It will open the dialog box. When you press Ctrl plus O, it will open the open dialog box. You need to specify the location of the file that is to be opened in the look-in field. So look-in field will be there in that field from which place you want to open a file. You need to select the files from that location and open it with the open command. So now, final one is making use of the help. Okay, help menu. So help menu will be located at the menu bar. You can click on the help menu from the menu bar, or else that will be opened with the list of available help topics. Or else you can press the F1 function key from the keyboard in order to open the help window. Okay. So in the search item text box, once the help window is opened with a list of available help topics, you can make use of the search item text box and you can enter the term to explore which term you want to search. No, you can type the term in the search item text box and you can explore it. Okay. You can search it. Okay. And then the quickest way to open the help function is by using the F1 function key. So like this, from the help menu, we can click on LibreOffice help and it will be opening like this, okay? So search item box is there now. In this search item box only, you need to type the topic which you want to search, about which content you want to search or you want to get the information. You can click here. It will give the information to you in the right side window, okay? So with this, we will end up the today's session. Thank you. So go through the video properly and take running notes. Whichever important key points you are able to understand from this, you just write it in the note, okay? And then the next class, you will get the test portions, test question paper related to this video. So prepare well. Thank you once again.